Hello, everybody. Thank you for checking out my video on mental health. I just want to talk about, how the stigmatization of mental health in society and in my own life have affected my treatment for my mental health and, just my willingness sometimes to even want to, speak out about it or even, defend myself when it comes to my mental health. But before I get started, I just want to give a disclaimer that this is no way directed at certain individual, and I hope that anybody that watches this video does not take offense. I know a lot of people take offense to my blog post that I post at bipolartater.com. I have been getting a lot of text messages from people that I used to be friends with that didn't want to be my friend anymore, saying how I write stuff and it hurts them. But anyways, this video is not about that. This video is more directed at how when you have a mental illness, you have to present a certain way. You have to, you have to be act like you have a mental illness, but you can't because you're so stigmatized, so stereotyped in society that people are afraid to, say that they're not okay. And instead, they just act like they're okay when deep down inside, you're not okay. And it's all right to not be okay. But based on how society, even like especially the healthcare system, because this healthcare system has totally failed me, it's they make it seem like it's not okay to be a, oh, it's not okay to not be okay. They make you. They stigmatize you. They make it so you don't want to get the treatment, so you're afraid to get the treatment. I've seen it in my own life. I went to the doctor because I had depression, I had anxiety, I didn't know how to deal with it. And instead of, being like, hey, at that time I hadn't slept in over 120 hours, instead of being like, hey, there's something wrong, you have a mental illness. No, I was told your mental illness is the inability to, just adapt. It's adjustment disorder. You're unable to deal with your own life. That's not a diagnosis that's true because I was, like I said, I was up 120 hours. That's not normal. But I was told by my doctor that's normal. And, to make matters worse, I got the wrong medication. I kept telling him, this medication's making me worse, making my symptoms worse. But, I wasn't listened to. I was just given more higher doses, more meds, And then eventually my mental health got so bad that I did an inpatient stay. And that was the same thing. I was just told that I had adjustment disorder, inability to handle life's events. And, I didn't have an anxiety. I didn't have depression. I was just unwilling and unable to deal with my life. But looking back, I didn't ask as a child before I was even in elementary school at probably the age of 2 or 3, maybe I think it was probably around 3, to be sexually abused by an older child. I didn't ask to, perform my first oral sex on someone at that young of an age. I deal with that trauma from that. Because I know that's not right at this age. Back then, I didn't know it wasn't right. And I just, kept it inside because I thought, hey, this is cool because this person's older. But now that I look back on it, no, it's caused me trauma. It makes me afraid to have interactions with people. I don't know why. It just messed me up mentally. That's a mental illness. I did not ask for this. People ask. Act like you asked for this or you don't have a mental illness just because you don't present it. But because of the way society is, people are afraid to admit that they have a mental illness. Me, that made I my mental illness was made worse. I suffered bullying for 8 years from people that were my coworkers. I just wanted to be accepted, but so I just was a verbal punching bag. People might have said, oh, you're a bitch, and all this other shit just because you are taking people's abuse, so you're their bitch, And you're a pussy, you're afraid to stand up for yourself. You know, you're an easy target. You're verbal punching bag for people. You're their comedic relief. You know, it's not right. At the time, you know, I just wanted to be accepted. I just didn't want to, you know, I didn't want that awkwardness at work, so I just left it happen, just kept bottling it up inside and inside. But really, it was making me nuts. You know, it's making my mental illness worse. And then it made me develop even another mental illness, which was social anxiety, where I'm afraid to interact with anyone because I'm afraid that I'm going to be judged. Just because back then I would say hi to someone and I would get judged. I would be told, oh, you're a flirt. You're flirting with that person just because you said hi to someone. That's just being a friendly, nice person. But no, I dealt with the bullying. I might not present like I have a mental illness because I bottle it up because I'm afraid of what people are gonna judge me, you know. I'm afraid the judgment. I'm afraid that people are gonna be like, oh, you're flirting with people, and you know, by that, I, you know, get that social anxiety, which is a mental illness, you know. And I have depression. I have anxiety. I, you know, finally found a psychiatrist that would actually listen to me, that actually cared and gave me the bipolar diagnosis with psychotic features. You know, that changed my life because somebody actually listened. Didn't say, oh, you have nothing wrong with you. You just have adjustment disorder. You don't have depression. You don't have anxiety. It's normal to not sleep for 120 hours. Fuck it is. It is not normal. But based on how society is, you know, it's not okay to not be okay. And that's not right. It should be okay to not be okay. You know? You shouldn't have to present like you have a mental illness for people to believe. You shouldn't have to prove that you have a mental illness for people to believe you. You know, if you're telling someone something's wrong, you know what's going on inside of you, so you know when something's wrong. You shouldn't have to prove it to other people. The people should listen because, you know, mental health is such a huge problem in society today because people are stigmatized. People are stereotyped. You know, you shouldn't have to worry about being stigmatized. You shouldn't have to worry about being stereotyped. I know people that, you know, have bad mental illnesses, but they're afraid to seek help because they're afraid that their employer is going to discipline them. They're afraid they're going to get fired. They're afraid their coworkers are going to look down on them. You know, it shouldn't be that way. Mental health should be the number one priority. You know, because your mental health is what makes you be the person that you are, and you shouldn't have to worry about other people judging. You shouldn't have to worry about people thinking you're a liar. Because I know in my experience, you know, people have told me, oh, you're just an attention seeker. Oh, there's nothing wrong with you. Oh, you're just making it up. You know, all this other stuff. And, you know, that just makes your mental health worse because you're afraid to get the treatment. You're afraid to ask for help because you're afraid what people are going to say. You're afraid how people are going to view you. You know, and me, I'm afraid, you know, I've been told many times, like when I ask for help, oh, you should just do an inpatient stay. No, anyone that actually listens to me or knows my story should know that the healthcare system failed me. They gave me that diagnosis of adjustment disorder, just pumped me full of different meds that were wrong. Even after I kept telling them that these meds are making my symptoms worse, they're not helping. You know, oh, but no, we'll just give you a higher dosage. We'll just give you another med that's the same, you know, an SSRI. I was at one point, I was on three SSRIs, which are the wrong medication for bipolar disorder. And I even told my doctor that I have a family history of bipolar disorder, but nobody would listen. I was just told I was normal, not sleeping. It was just part of adjustment disorder. You know, it's a insane reaction to an insane event and all this other stuff. But, you know, when you get down to it, it's a mental illness that I have. I shouldn't have to hide it. I should be able to get the help I need. I shouldn't have to worry about going to my doctor and being told that there's nothing wrong and just being given the wrong medications, even after I tell them that they're the wrong medications. You know, it took me a long time to find somebody who would actually listen to me. I had that in my therapist. I have that in my psychiatrist. My psychiatrist wants to help me. She actually says, hey, I'm here to help you get better, and that's what I want to do. I want to get you better. I don't want you to have to suffer. I don't want you to have to deal with all the stuff that you're dealing with your mental illness. You know, that's a big thing, but it's hard to find. You know, I, in my history, in the last year and a half, I went to my PCP because I had issues. I had a psychiatrist that I talked to that, you know, I told I had issues that told me I was normal adjustment disorder. Another psychiatrist that told me. And then when I did my inpatient after I went to the ER, when they had that, the third doctor told me I had adjustment disorder, I saw three different psychiatrists while I was doing my inpatient stay, and they all told me that it was adjustment disorder. I was just unable to deal with life's events. I just couldn't handle life. And that there was nothing else wrong with me. So that's a lot of doctors that failed me. So the healthcare industry failed me miserably. They gave me the wrong medications. They made me so manic that I was unable to make clear and sound decisions, you know, and now I'm facing legal trouble for something that I have no recollection of doing that they say I did, you know. I don't know what happened. I don't know if I did what they say I did, but all I know is that when I got the psychiatrist that I have, got off the wrong medications, got on the right medications, my life has changed. I am more clear. I'm able to make great decisions. You know, I have great recollection. You know, I'm still trying to get off the wrong medications. I'm still on two medications that are incorrect, but it's a long process, you know, getting off the wrong meds, getting on the right medications. But, you know, I've lost all my friends. I have one friend left, and that's it. And, you know, so now I just am at the point, you know, I'm tired of being told that I'm a verbal punching bag. I'm tired of being told I'm an easy target. I'm tired of being told that I'm a liar. I'm tired of being told that I'm faking it. You know, I'm tired of being told I'm an attention seeker, and I'm tired of just being told that I don't show as somebody that has a mental illness just because I've dealt with this for so long that I've learned to put on the mask when I'm on stage in front of other people, you know. And then the people that I am comfortable with, I don't show my mental illness because I feel comfortable for me because they make me feel better. They make me feel like a great person, you know. And that's how it should be. It shouldn't be that you're stigmatized. It shouldn't be that you're stereotyped. It shouldn't be not okay to not be okay. It should be okay to not be okay. You know, mental health is a big issue, and you know, it's sad that society stigmatizes. It's sad that they stereotype you. But, you know, I'm here to say it's okay to not be okay. And, you know, really, when you have a mental illness and you're able to stand up and advocate for yourself, you're not afraid to tell your story. Your pain becomes your biggest asset, and that gives you the strength to carry on, and no one can take that away from you. And it sucks that people have to go through this pain, but it's a, you know, once you learn to harness it, you can make a world of difference. So I'm here to say it's okay to not be okay, and your pain is actually your greatest asset because that gives you the strength to carry on and to prove people wrong, especially when you are in those situations where people are telling you you're a liar, you're telling you that you're full of shit, they're telling you that you're an attention seeker when you know you have a mental illness. You just don't want to show it because those people are horrible people. Those people judge you. Those people don't want you to get mental health because they treatment because they want you to be that verbal punching bag. They want you to be their bitch. They want you to be their comedic relief. But that's not okay. Those people are the ones that have the mental illness because they're afraid to admit that they have a mental illness. Because in my eyes, being that mean and bullying someone and, you know, turning someone into your verbal punching bag because you know they have a mental illness, you know they're afraid to stand up for you because they have a mental illness. They're the ones that have the true mental illness. They're the ones that suck, and they're the ones that should be afraid to admit it because they are horrible people. And, you know, those that are afraid, that aren't afraid, even though they might be afraid, but they're not afraid because they have that strength, they have that devotion, they have that fight to get the treatment that they need. those are the ones that need to share their stories. Those are the ones that need to tell what they've gone through, what they've been through, because that's the way that mental health will get destigmatized, the stigma will end, and people will not be afraid to tell their story and not be afraid to not be okay. So thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe, please like this video, and please keep the po comments positive, because I know long time ago I made videos and people were just like constantly negative comments attacking me, which is again bullying who have the mental illnesses. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe, and hopefully you like this video and I can make more and people watch. Thanks.